New York Rock!
What's up, everybody? It's Phil from New York Rocks TV. Stay tuned, you're watching New York Rocks, baby. Who rocks better than us?
Nobody rocks like New York Rocks. We rock the best.
New York rocks, New York rocks, yeah, New York rocks, New York rocks, yeah, New York rocks, New York rocks, yeah, New York rocks, New York rocks, hey, Phil from Anna Rock across the USA, I feel from Anna Rocks, yeah, every day, I feel from Anna Rocks and he's coming your way, he's coming to your town in the USA, yeah.
You want to imitate us, but you ain't gonna win. If you want to rock our way, come on down, hey, hey, we'll let you in.
You can't stop the New York Rocks, yeah, you can't stop New York Rocks, yeah, you can't stop New York Rocks, yeah, you can't stop New York Rocks, 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 yeah.
Everybody, this is Phil from New York Rocks. What a great opening that was. Man, who's better than you guys to open up a show with a song like that? Wasn't that great? You got AJ
great.
Here.
Great.
Give a hand for AJ Piro from Twisted Sister. Rocking out.
And Sal's jacket's even better. Yeah. I mean, how could you beat that?
You mentioned, you said that song's a good song.
That's
right?
A great song. Yeah. That's a great song. I just told you that.
New York Rocks is great.
That's a great song.
Because you're on it.
Nah, not because I'm on it. Yeah. Just, you know.
Yeah, it is. It's all right. I can say that.
All right.
We got a great show, eh? We got a lot of great guests here. Yep. We have Angelo Coppola. This is his rocks. This is the future of rock over here.
Thanks for having me on, Phil.
Oh, man. Thanks for coming on. You came all the way from Detroit, Rock City.
Detroit, yeah. Rock City.
Yeah. Yeah. Rocking out. He came down with his dad, his mom, and his sister.
Yep.
Dad's Joe. Joe. Yep. And mom's Gail, and you have a sister, Gina.
Gina, yep.
Yeah, I remembered. Cool. We went a lot of miles to come down here.
Yeah, it took 10 hours.
10 hours?
Yep.
Wow, that's pretty good, 10 hours.
Cool.
Yeah.
You drove right fast.
Took me 27 one time going from Detroit to New York.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, but I had to go through Florida, that's why.
Well, you were hanging out with all the guys from Twisted Sister.
Well, yeah, of course.
They derailed you, you know what I mean? So we got Jay over here, Jay Boryea.
Yeah.
Actor, stuntman.
It's great to be on the show.
Thanks for coming down. All right, Jay's been in a lot of movies. And he started out, how'd you start out with show business? How'd you start out?
I used to be a high school phys ed teacher and basketball coach. Right. And used to work as a bouncer.
Where is this now? Where is this?
And over in Jersey, New Jersey, Scotch Pines. And used to have to work as a bouncer because, you know, teachers don't make a lot of money. Mm-hmm. And one of my buddies that was a bouncer became a stuntman and got into business. And I went out to California to visit him on a vacation one time. And he took me around. He took me a couple shows. And one of the people I met was Mr. T. Remember Mr. T from the Rocky movies? Mm-hmm. And I sat at, you know, I snuck in Universal Studios. And I sat there and I talked to him for about 2 hours. He used to be a bouncer. He's the same size as me. And kind of encouraged me. He said, well, you know, why don't you give it a try? So I went to my buddy. I said, what do I have to do to, you know, get into this? And he told me, he said, you know, get some pictures done. And I had a martial arts background. I had just gotten my black belt. So what I did is I put some pictures together. I sent them out. And I got hired on a film called The Last Dragon. Mm-hmm. And I worked 3 days as an extra, and I thought that was pretty exciting, just working, you know, kind of background.
Martial arts movie?
Yeah, it was a martial arts movie with a guy named Ty Mock and Vanity. Mm-hmm. It was done by Berry Gordy. It was a Motown picture.
I heard of him.
My friend was working on a picture, and they said, well, you need some more stunt guys to do a fight.
Right.
So he says, my friend here is in martial arts. He goes, he's a good guy. So he put me up, and I got my Screen Actors Guild. Yeah. So I got my Screen Actors Guild card and did a fight scene and wound up doubling one of the actors who was a little bit bigger and getting beat up by a bunch of little kids. And,
that was a while ago. What year was that?
It was about 1983, 1984. So I've been in it about 24 years now. Mm-hmm. So I liked it so much, I taught for another year, then I quit and went into it full time, went out to California for a while. I was out there for 4 years and liked it better back on the East Coast and came back here and work mostly out of New York now.
You got an amazing resume. You've been in a lot of films, but I see, let's say you did Taxi?
Yeah.
Analyze that?
Yeah.
Analyze TV, right?
No, that was actually a movie with Queen Latifah.
Oh, all right.
And Jimmy Fallon.
The new one that just came out.
Yeah. Did some stunt driving in that, driving a taxi cab. And Analyze That was with
De Niro.
Yeah. We did a big fight scene in Rikers Island, which was a lot of fun to do. And yeah, that was a good film.
You were
good
in another film with De Niro, too, right?
Right. City by the Sea, that was... played a character named Picasso, and I was a drug dealer.
Right.
And for the film, I had to shave my head, and I had to get my whole face and my head tattooed, my arms tattooed. I looked like Mike over there, you know. And that I had some funny experiences with that when I am in a fight scene, and I get killed, I get stabbed.
Right.
So the night before that, they put these prosthetic cuts on me, and I had this shaved head and a face all tattooed. And as I was driving home, I went over the bridge, and they had Port Authority cops taking the tolls.
Right.
And I went to hand him the toll, and he wouldn't take it. He kind of was edging towards his gun, you know.
He thought something was up.
I said, it's for a film. He goes, I thought you were going to kill me, you know. And then when I went into the 7-Eleven, everybody walked out, so I guess I was scary looking. But that was fun. I got thrown in the East River on that.
That's cool.
You have a lot of speaking roles. They were all speaking roles. At first, you started out, you didn't probably have much speaking roles. You did mainly all stunts,
right?
And then you worked your way into starting to actually do some acting.
Yeah.
Who inspired you to start, you know, actually doing lines and helped you out like that?
Some of the actors that I really liked, De Niro, of course, you know, and I did a film with John Malkovich and Matt Damon called Rounders.
Right.
And working with those guys was like going to Yale Drama School or something, because they're really good actors, and I learned a lot from them.
Right.
And I've kind of found my niche, because a lot of times they like to hire a stunt person that can act. You don't always double an actor, you play a character.
Right.
And sometimes there's dialogue involved. And some guys are great stuntmen, you know, can do 26-story high falls, but if you ask them to do a line, they're not so good.
Yeah.
I can act a little bit, so I can do a little bit of both. So
how'd you meet up with Mike?
Mike and I have worked together many times. The first time we worked together was on One Life to Live. We played bikers.
You had a romance.
Not my type.
I think I saw that episode, matter of fact.
We've done One Life to Live several times. We did a movie called Earthly Possessions with Susan Sarandon.
Right.
Always biker guys, you know.
Yeah.
So,
Mike? Nah.
I would think he would be a lawyer.
Conan O'Brien, right? We've done some skits on Conan O'Brien, and we worked together a few times.
You know,
that's impressive.
Whenever somebody sees my reel, you see Jay, because I'm on him with David Letterman.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm on him with the next in All My Children, One Life to Live, because we all go together.
Yeah.
You know, we all get called for the same stuff.
Cool. Well, I'm in on this, right?
Soon? You're in?
Yeah.
You got the tattoos.
Wow. Yeah.
There you go.
You're in, you know that.
You're the man, Mike.
IMD. You're in IMD.
IMD?
What is it? International Movie Database?
IMDB.
Oh, IMDB, yeah.
Well, I ain't in it, so.
That's a secret society.
Like acting, you know?
You know?
I mess up, so it must be like acting, right? How about this guy over here?
Yeah.
Talk about yourself.
Well,
leaving the kid out.
When I was 2 years old, my dad bought a drum set from his friend, and a lot of times he just like sit me up there and I just start making beats. So then when I was 8, we sent in a tape to this TV show called America's Most Talented Kids. And we liked that show because we watched it on TV and we thought it'd be cool if I could get on there.
Yeah.
And we sent in a tape to them with me wearing the Kiss makeup and I played Rock and Roll All Night. And we were surprised because about a month later, we had a call and it was them and they said they wanted us to come out to California.
How come they waited a month and you were like, ah, how come it's taking so long, right?
The show is
I'm great. I'll be home. I'm great.
Yeah. So
you didn't start up with the pots and pans either?
No, actually, I just started out from the kit.
That was me and Bernard with the pots and pans. Me and Bernard with the Tupperware and the pots and pans.
Your dad was like, I ain't got no pots and pans. You go right
He's
on the drum.
Go right for the drum set.
Yeah.
Good.
And what age was that?
Nah, they didn't even have drum sets now, some of the rock stars.
Yeah. How old were you when you first started, on the drums?
I've been playing for about 9 years now, so since I was 2.
Wow. Good for you.
How about, let's say, your sister's here. Talk a little bit about your sister. We'll bring her up a little later. We only got a limited amount of seats here.
Yeah,
but
my sister, she's a competition dancer, and she's been dancing since she was about 2 also. And a little bit later, she's going to do a dance solo, and she's going to do a hip-hop dance.
Cool. Excellent.
Yeah. Now, how'd you get into Kiss? Is that your favorite group, right? Kiss?
Yeah. Right. Well, my dad was always a big fan of Kiss, so like he would put on the music in the car when I was really little, and I just really liked it. Yeah.
Or you would hear the song like when you first heard Kiss, it was like you don't know whether or not I like it, but then you start listening to it more and you kind of grew on you. A little bit.
Well, I don't think Kiss will probably ever grow on me now because I like them so much.
Yeah. Now you met Kiss. Did you meet anybody from Kiss yet?
I met the guitar player and singer Paul Stanley when he was signing autographs one time. Mm-hmm. And then the next day he was in Michigan, so I got to go see his concert. It was right by my house at the Emerald Theater.
Right.
And I met the current drummer, Eric Singer.
Mm-hmm.
And
Just recently, right?
Yeah.
Indianapolis Kiss Expo, you were there, right?
Yeah, well, I met him at the first Kiss Expo. I played at the Chicago Kiss Expo. Mm-hmm. And I met him again because he got me backstage passes to an Alice Cooper concert.
Cool. He plays the drums, Eric Singer, for Alice Cooper, too.
Well, we were just on tour with them 2 years ago.
Alice Cooper. Did you open for them or?
Well, it was a co-headlining thing, and that we were talking about. I was talking to Eric Singer about,
AJ remembers because AJ been around for a while and actually you toured with Kiss, right? Too, didn't you? Once, twice, or whatever.
Not toured. We did a lot of the festivals that are done.
Right.
A lot of times you're on 3-day festivals.
Right.
You're on the same bill as a lot of these bands.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not really, touring is going out for 6 months and whatever. We'll be on a lot of, we've done some shows with Kiss and Crew and, a lot of those bands. But it'd be like big festival type things. So you're hanging out and you're, schmoozing with everybody.
Angela, I wanted to ask you though, did you ever see Kiss in concert play live?
Yeah, I saw them once when I was, 3, and it was on New Year's Eve.
You can remember.
Wow.
It was on New Year's Eve, and we had a suite.
Yeah.
And it was me, my grandpa, and my dad, and I loved it. I was standing on the chair and everything, rocking out.
You were 3 when you
were? 3.
Yeah.
He beat me. I had to wait till I was 17.
And I went again.
I was 14. I got out of school.
I seen Kiss. My first concert actually was Kiss, 1977, at the Garden, December 16th, the day before my birthday.
Wow.
My father took me and my friend, who was only like 15 years old. He wouldn't let me go to the city by myself. So he went to the concert, but he sat upstairs in the nosebleed with the guard, and he let us watch the show. I was just blown away. It was alive too.
I was 14, Kiss opening for Black Sabbath
at
the Beacon Theater.
See?
See?
And I cut out of school and I went online. I got tickets.
Yeah.
And I stayed in the city that day.
70 what?
72.
Wow.
Wow.
72. That was. I was sitting right here, and Gene Simmons was right there, and the fire was just like, and I'm like, whoa, what the hell was that?
Yeah.
And it was like the, it was.
But
it was
you've
pretty
got
cool.
a lot of influences from Kiss and let's say the New York Dolls and stuff like that, right, AJ? Tell
the
people about that.
In the day, when Kiss was forming, JJ French, who was our guitar player, was actually in the band with Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley
Wicked
when it was
Lester.
Called Wicked Lester.
Yeah.
Okay. And then he didn't like the direction they were going in as far as regarding the music. So he went and formed Twisted Sister, and they got Ace Frehley and Peter Criss and formed Kiss.
Right.
I don't know if it was influence, but I think they were more Dolls, T-Rex, like the Glitter back then, more than what the Kiss was. I think the Kiss was more along the theatrical, you know, theatrical makeup, where the New York Dolls and that stuff was just to go out
glamour.
And be outlandish. Yeah, glamour. It was just outlandish. Mm-hmm. So they were kind of, you know, it was kind of like a race to the top, and obviously, you know, Kiss got the first break, but.
You remember back in the day, AJ used to play at a lot of clubs, you know, right in the island, because you're from Staten Island, and these guys used to play down at the Factory
and Rock Palace.
I used to see come play, and
right.
it was such a spectacle, you know, because the hair and everything, and D being so tall, you know, and then he used to put the heels on, you know, and the hair, and then you were there with all the makeup and the hair.
And I was in the back, so you didn't know how short I was.
Yeah, we didn't see.
He said, wow, he's big, and I'd come down and be like this big.
The drummers always seem to be. You never really see too many, like, huge, tall drummers. The drummers are, like, a little smaller.
You know what, because it's better, like a catcher. It's better to be more compact than to be lanky, because then you're like, your arms start going like this, and like, you know. And
they like to sit down. They like to sit down and eat.
We have no choice.
Okay, we're gonna get back to Jay. Jay, talk a little about what projects you're involved with now.
I just finished this TV show called 6 Degrees, which is on Channel 7. Mm-hmm. Played like a crazed construction worker, goes around knocking down the wrong walls with a sledgehammer. Right. And one of the other things I'm doing is a friend of mine's writing a sitcom at this point, and he's going to put me in it, and I'm going to play a football coach.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm looking forward to that. That's in kind of pre-production right now. Mm-hmm. So those are some of the things.
Talk about, let's say, what's the, like, craziest stunt that you had to, you know, do in front of, like, the most dangerous kind of stunt?
Three of them come to mind. City by the Sea that I mentioned before. At the end of the fight, I get stabbed and I get killed, and they throw me off a 5-foot wall into the East River, which
is nasty. Now, we have a clip of that.
Yeah.
Is that on this clip?
No, you won't see it, because they actually cut that from the movie, but it's in the trailer. But I had to go into the water. It was 45 degrees.
Wow.
Plus, I had to get, like, four different kinds of shots, because the East River is really nasty.
And was it in the wintertime? Or?
Yeah, it was February, and the water was just freezing.
Wow.
And the hard part was...
Right?
Yeah, and the hard part was... I'm dead, so when I hit the water, you know, when you hit cold water, you jump. I can't, because I'm dead, so I just got to hit the water and hold my breath as long as I can, because they wanted to catch me floating down the river.
Well, they figured they can get another stunt. All right, just get another stunt. Don't worry about
it. Another one I did, I had a stunt double, David Ogden Stiers, for a movie called Jungle to Jungle, and they took a tarantula the size of my hand and had to crawl up my head, on top of my head, which I had to shave my head again for that.
God.
And then they had another one where they put the camera over me and they put the tarantula on my chest.
Mm-hmm.
And then the wrangler would come in and poke it so its fangs would come out and go, you know. And he kept telling me, you know, if they sting, there's no antidote. So, you know, but if we get you to the hospital within 24 hours, you might live, you know.
Yeah.
So that was a little crazy. So
you got to be a little brave, you know. You can't be chicken-hearted, you know.
That's it.
That leaves me out. I guess I'm not doing any stuntman work.
But another one I did was for a movie called Rooftops. I did a 30-foot backward high fall off a breakaway fire escape.
Wow.
And it was a timing thing, because somebody throws a basketball at me as I walk into the window, and then the fire escape breaks away and I fall. So that was a pretty tough one.
Now, that you were in that movie, or were you doing a stunt for somebody?
No, I was actually a character in that. I played like a street gang member of a drug dealer again. And it was actually a pretty good part for me.
Right.
And it was early on in my career, and, you know, speaking about the acting and getting lines, I was really happy because I had about 8 lines in it. And, you know, I did my acting and my stunts. I actually got to choreograph some of the fights. Mm-hmm. We did two or three fights in it. And then I get killed with the you know, going off the balcony.
Do you ever get hurt on any?
Yeah, knock wood, I've been lucky. I dislocated my shoulder and had a hairline fracture of my hand. Right. So other than that, I've been lucky.
All right, talk about some of the clips that we have, because we brought some clips with us.
Yeah.
Now, talk a little about the clips.
Oh, you'll see different clips from TV show Spencer for Hire.
Okay.
One of my big talents is getting beat up. I'm always the bad guy. I'm always getting beat up or I'm getting shot. So you'll see clips of me and Spencer for Hire getting beat up and shot.
Yeah.
I make the stars look good. That's what I do.
That's what it is.
The bad guys always work because the stars want to look good.
You could be bigger and badder, but
right.
You know, the stars got to look good, you know?
That's it. They want big guys because it looks better when they beat you up or when they shoot you. And you see Spencer for Hire, you'll see clips from Third Watch. Some of the other rooftops, you'll see some fights in that, and a little bit from, I think there's one in there from General Hospital, where I actually got to do some of the beating up.
Mike's in One Life to Live. I think he's got that part locked down.
That's right. They love him over there. They love Mike at One
he's
Life
a regular.
And all my children.
Yeah.
Mike and I were...
Got a Mikey Tattoo.
Yeah.
He helps me out so much. He's like the catalyst. He's like my brother. I had to go and call him and get advice.
I just want to tell you something. I did a movie with Jay. It was called
Earthly Possessions.
Mm-hmm. And if you ever wonder what stunt fighters ever do, Jay was beat up by Steven Dorff. Mm-hmm. Okay? And if you know him, he's about 5'5", 130 pounds. And you have to rent this movie because you're going to see Jay beat up. Kicked around the bar, kicked in the, where I can't mention, you name it, thrown over the bar stool, punched in the face, except Steven Dorff's not a stunt fighter, and half the punches were landing. And this take that you watch in the movie, they filmed it at least 35 times before they got it right. And I said to Jay, it's all your stunt stuff, man. This is too much. Man. What he went through that day, wow.
Oh, you were in the movie too?
Yeah.
Okay. Ah,
it's Mike pretty was cool. Another biker. Who didn't come to my aid when I was getting beat up.
All right. I wanted to come to his aid, but Steven Dorff went over to the director and said that they're not going to believe it. So instead, Steven Dorff says, anybody got a problem with this? And I go, no.
All right. How about Angelo? You want to do some stunt work when you get over? Nah, you stay away from
stunts. I'll stick with the drums.
Stick with music. It's tough, and the music's tough enough.
Yeah.
Stunts on the drums.
That's it.
Yeah.
All right, AJ, so what's going on with you now that you're part of New York Rocks?
Yeah, I mean, I'm proud to be part of it. This is great. Yeah. I love everybody, Mike, Sal, everybody, right. Bill, you know.
Got Chaz wailing out.
Chaz is little here.
Big Bad Bill. Sal can't fit the mayor.
The mayor, of course.
Mayor of rock and roll, mayor of New York.
Rock.
Yeah. I want you. Is that it? I'm not rocking.
It's
there would be
like
no rocking if we were
something
have the
like
food.
That.
I had one question for you.
Okay, years ago I met William Smith, and I was a big William Smith fan because he's just, you know, and I had asked him a question because we got on the same subject of how do you feel about actors doing their own stunts, and William Smith, he said to me, he goes, yeah, they do their own stunts when they want to or when they can. He goes, otherwise they call people like us.
Yeah.
Now, obviously you guys are the ones that are behind the scene.
Right.
And the other ones, like he's just said, you make the actors look good.
Right.
But I mean, it's got to be tough sometimes to watch, you know, watch yourself.
It takes, when actors want to do their own stunts, right. It kind of, you know, takes work away from stunt guys.
Sure.
But because of insurance purposes, a lot of times, like the big name actors, you know, the companies won't let them do that.
Right.
Like, I just stunt doubled recently James Gandolfini in a movie called All the King's Men.
Right, yeah. Right.
And it was basically a scene where a near miss with two cars coming head on,
right.
A truck and a car. And all the other stuff, they leave him in the car.
Right.
But when you're going to do that stunt, you can't have him in the car for insurance
right.
purposes.
And that's
so that's what they put
is
me
that
in there
strict?
For.
That's what I was. That was like my question. Is it only because of insurance prices, or is it because of the fact that they don't want to take a chance that something's going to happen?
I've worked with Stallone. I did a movie called Lockup with Sylvester Stallone.
I saw that.
You may see that in one of the clips. And he likes doing a lot of his own stunts. And he can. He's very athletic. He's very good.
Right.
But in the movie that we did a football sequence. He actually hurt his knee, and he had to go to the hospital for a day or two. So they got to change the shooting schedule a little bit.
Right.
So if it's a really, really big one, like a 30-story high fall or something really dangerous, most actors know enough that let the stunt guy do it.
It could stop the production.
Yeah, that's
right. Right.
That was,
exactly.
Yeah, that
and
was,
they got everything, you know, they're paying other actors there too.
Right.
So I figured if they put a stunt guy in, if something happens to that stunt guy, they always, you know, can replace him, get another stunt guy, not have to stop the whole production.
Exactly.
Basically, that's about it.
Cool. Yeah.
But you know what? I want to take this time out to thank the sponsors, because the New York Rocks need sponsors and we need food. And we have the food, and it's provided by Big Al's Pizza. Give it up for Big Al's.
Good pizza, Big Al.
Big Al's is on Highland Boulevard between Armstrong and Nelson.
Yes.
Right on Highland.
Yes.
So if you want to check out Big Al's right here.
Chicago style.
Yeah, that's delicious Chicago pizza. Yeah. That's a wise guy right there.
Yeah, that's the other right. That guy in fiction. Yeah.
Who's the rat?
Who's the rat? Two. Page two.
And how about this? The menu of Planet Wings.
Yeah.
You gotta have chicken.
Yeah.
It's like the best of all worlds. Planet Wings got two locations. You got Lincoln Avenue on Holland.
Right.
And then you have over here at the Forest Avenue Shopping Plaza, Planet Wings. Give it up for Planet Wings. And, you know, those are two food sponsors. Also, we have some other sponsors that are coming on the show. We have Arthur for Tubman from
Freedom From Your Job Group. And you can find Arthur at www.freedomfromyourjob.net.
But also, we'd like to thank Dozer.
Island Tattoo, yes.
That's
who hooked us up.
Yeah.
That's who hooked us up. Yeah. He does all my work.
He said, I got something for you.
I got something. We talked on the phone today. Yeah. You were down there.
I was like, oh, he's going to give me another tattoo. I was like, I'm going to have tattoos all over me.
Yeah, he does all my work. I mean, Dozer's the only guy that does my work. I've been kind of chicken to go back and have the rest of my back done. Yeah. He's like, because you know how big he is. Yeah. And he's like, it doesn't hurt. And I'm like, ugh. But
digging in with you.
Yeah, I mean, Dozer, Tiny, Andre, Matt, Anthony, and Oogie. Oogie.
I got a new girl, but I don't know her name. Yeah. But these
guys are great. I mean, if you ever get a chance to just go by the shop and just check them out. And they're great people, too. I mean, they've been friends of mine for as long as they've been there.
I want to thank Joe from Long Island, too. Joe
from
Long Island helping out.
Yes, absolutely.
Also, we have Joey Norman. Joey Norman from the Lowriders Motorcycle Club.
Joey's a good friend. We're good friends.
And the Motorcycle Association is part of that. And I want to welcome Andre from the film Priceless.
Yes.
He's in the audience here today.
Yeah.
Priceless. Also, we have Mad Dog.
Dog.
We have Mad. He's
there. Mad Dog.
We have another actor here from the movie Doughboys. Gaetano from the movie Doughboys. He's also over here. And we're all watching it. We got Tommy Guns helping out over
Tommy
here.
Tommy Guns.
Tommy. We got Jennifer and my man Johnny Bianco.
Yeah.
Leo. We have Leo.
Leo's there.
We got to cover everybody, but getting back to...
Let's get back to Angelo over here.
What do you got? What do you got going on next now? You're doing like an album or something, right? You're producing an album?
Oh, well, there's this Kiss tribute band. They're called Christine 16, and they're a bunch of high school kids, and they play Kiss music, and there was a first one, and now this is the second one, and I got to play drums on three of the songs. And I got to go in the studio, and it was really fun doing all this.
Where are they from, this band?
Huh? They're from Quebec.
And you went up there, or they came to you?
Well, we just went in the studio, and we recorded, and we sent the music to them. My dad sent it to them. Mm-hmm.
Now, talk about, you did something called Pound for Pound. What is that? Talk
to me
about
that. I put out a debut CD last year in June, and it's called Pound for Pound. Mm-hmm. And it's all original songs written by me and my dad.
Cool.
Wow.
Very yeah. nice. Cool. Very nice.
You're going to play some, right? On the show.
Yeah, I'll play
some later.
Yeah. Absolutely.
All right, AJ says he might play a little bit on the show too later. Yeah,
only
on, maybe,
if,
right?
if Mike has to, Mike and Sal have to coax me a little bit.
Right. Have to, yeah, but finally we can get to. We had so many great drummers on the show. Actually, we had Liberty DeVito,
yeah.
and somebody stole our drum set, and we couldn't catch him. He, boom, he was gone. You know what I mean? Then we had you come on the last show with Bernard. And we didn't get you to play the drums.
Well,
nobody gets to play.
It was
I got all these great drummers here. Nobody gets to play the drums. And then we had you at Fenix too. We still didn't get you to play the drums.
Yeah, but Phil, I'm here. I'm gonna be a fixture yeah. with you, so I'm always here.
Yeah, fixture.
I'm a fixture.
But then we're doing the horror convention. Remember, we're doing the chiller.
Yeah, the
chiller
horror convention. Yes. Yes.
Me and AJ are gonna do the horror convention. When that's coming up Saturday.
Yeah,
Saturday.
It's coming up Saturday, yeah. and I'll be there and I'll be signing stuff.
It's a couple of days. Friday,
Saturday, and Sunday.
And Sunday.
But you're coming Saturday, and we're gonna film most of it, and
to talk about the movie, we have the guys from the movie Knock Knock.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I forgot to mention Anthony Palladino. I'm sorry. We're gonna put him on the show, and we got Sal Sirchia, the mayor of rock and roll, but the mayor of New York.
Yeah, the mayor.
He's so big. and I love him to death. You know, whoever don't love Sal, forget about it. They get a beating. You know what I mean?
No.
What's not to love?
No.
He's a great guy.
It's not a thing in the world. You're the best of the best of the best.
That's right.
That's why you're here for New York Rocks, man.
Film movie stuff.
We rock the best, man.
That's the thing they say about you, Phil. I never believed it.
Yeah. The band is getting better and better and better. Not that it wasn't better, the best, and now it's like.
Mike, baby.
Yeah, Mike.
I have to say, if you really think about it, Mike wrote the New York Rocks theme song, right?
That's right. Yeah. Yeah.
Mike's always telling me. Mike's always kidding around. Phil, I hope you appreciate this.
Remember,
I'm like, God, I appreciate it. Please, Mike. Please.
Phil, do you remember how it got started? The very first show we came on, the Halloween show.
Halloween show, yeah.
And we were doing the Monster Mash.
Yeah.
That Mike just started singing New York Rocks on top of the Monster Mash chords.
Yeah.
Which those chords are done by a million songs.
Right.
I mean, so.
And a light bulb.
He just wrote the bridge to it. And now you got an original New York Rocks theme song.
Yeah, baby.
Well, you have to give love to the band, the New York Rocks band.
Yeah.
That's why the New York Rocks band, you know? All right, so we got so many other things to discuss and talk about. Well, I'd like to throw a little plug on for the Aquarian. It's Aquarian Weekly, and, you know, on the front page over here, we got Hell Yeah! What a new band, Hell Yeah, right?
Yeah.
That's got the guy from Pantera in there.
Yeah, Vinnie
right?
Paul. Vinnie Paul plays drums.
Yeah.
And I don't know who the other guys are. They're a good looking band, though, right?
Yeah, well, you know, those cute rock and roll guys, you know.
Really
what I mean?
Good looking band.
Yeah. That's why I got into music, you know?
That's why I got into music.
All right, so if you want a copy of this, you can just come to me. You know, I give it away, you know? So it's Aquarian Weekly. You get it every week. Come see me, you know? I'll take care of you.
And that's a nice thing because a lot of things aren't free nowadays. It
says
free.
$2, but I give it away.
Well, that's what I'm saying. You know, a lot of things they say are free, but they're really not.
Yeah, well, you're New York Rocks, though.
That's right. That's what I'm saying.
You got the hookup. Well, there has an event over here. Joey Norman's having a 13th annual bike blessing. You're going to bless a bike.
Yeah.
You're gonna bike
you know what they do, right? They hang an old Japanese bike up or something, and they beat the crap out of it.
Really?
I think that's it, yeah.
All right, you got to show up to that.
It's a pretty cool. Yeah, I mean it's a pretty cool event. I've been to a few of them years ago, and
it's Mardi Gras.
Yeah, the lowriders always have a great party, and the people that go are super, and you get all the local biker clubs that everybody comes down. They all hang out. They break bread. It's a really cool thing, you know, that happens.
Well, there's a lot of police and firemen down there too.
Yeah,
bikes aren't just about biker guys. They get a bad rap, you know what I mean? Because a lot of them are professionals these days, you know.
A lot. Well, the New York Knights have their the police organization, I believe, that ride, and then you have the firemen that ride. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of organizations that do have stuff like that. But, you know, nowadays bikes are just a normal thing, you know.
All right. So also what I'm doing is I'm also doing auditions for Fenix Studios or Who Rocks the Best. And we got a little plug for Fenix Studios. And if you want to come on Rock Out on New York Rocks, Fenix Studios, you can check it out right here down on Ottakill Road. And you can come rock out on New York Rocks. We'll make you a video and we'll put you on TV and you'll have a little thing to rock out with. All right? So I think I about covered most of the stuff, you know?
I believe
can't
so.
Forget, you know?
I believe so.
All right, so what's going on now with the stunts? You gonna do more stunts soon?
Yeah, again, more fights. In this sitcom, I'll probably take some hits in that, and we're hoping that gets pushed up. And you know, I'm always training to get better. Mm-hmm. You know, I've taken some stunt driving courses. I train with Bobby Orr, who's a famous stunt driver. He went to his school out in California, and we go and we train. We get the airbags, and a friend of mine, stunt coordinator named Roy Anderson. Yeah. We go up to his house and we jump out of the tree in his backyard and
practice.
I think it's a little strange, you know. This guy's jumping out of trees.
Grown men, right?
Men jumping out the trees over there. What's going on?
And then we get the trampoline, and the trampoline's behind the garage, and they see guys popping up over the garage, and they don't know what's going on.
Do you know
what
BJ Worth?
I've heard the name.
Yeah, he did. Actually, if you ever saw a Twisted video, We're Not Gonna Take It, I Want to Rock.
Right, yeah.
He did the stunts for that because we're blowing somebody out a window.
Right. Wasn't that you busting through the door?
Yeah, that was it. Yeah, but no. But the thing is that the guy going out the window. That's you know, that's the stunt man that's doing that.
That's the guy that messed around with you. You threw him out the window.
Yeah, yeah.
The guy that, you know, well, bothers you.
Yeah, I mean, there was Mark Medcalf, who was the actor, and then B.J. Worth played his stunt double. So, he was big. I mean, in the 80s, obviously, he was big in the industry as a stuntman. But
All right. Well, we have all the guests to come on the show, so why don't we bring up some of the other guests? We'll take a little break and we'll rock out with the New York Rocks band and. Maybe we'll get Angelo to come up and do a little number with the band. How about that?
I think we should.
We got to hear some rock over here, all right?
Shake it.
Come on, baby, make me feel.
Shake it up, baby.
Come on and make me feel so good, y'all.
Make it all right, yeah.
How many tracks? These are all original songs. You said it before that you and your dad wrote all the songs, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the album is called Pound for Pound. You could buy this on your website, correct?
Yeah, there's a link to a website called CD Baby.
CD Baby. I bet you my record won't be on there because I don't have one. So if you get yeah, baby, CD Baby.
You're the mayor, baby. So, don't worry about it.
If you go to CDBaby.com, right?
Yeah.
You could get Angelo Coppola's Pound for Pound CD. And is it a good price, Angelo? I got mine for free, folks, because I'm the mayor of rock and roll. So, you know, that's the least that can do to get mine for free.
There you go.
So let's have a big hand for Angelo. Remember, he drove all the way from Detroit with his mom and dad just to be on New York Rock Hill up there.
So we have another guest up here, Gaetano. Here he is.
Hey, you got it right.
Yeah,
well, wow. Let me tell you, that is one talented kid.
That kid,
absolutely. My God!
Yeah. I think that kid belongs right here in the aquarium, right in the front. He absolutely belongs, right?
Absolutely.
He belongs on the front page of everything.
He's on the next copy of the aquarium over here, rocking out over here. All right. It was a great job. All right, Gaetano. What have you been up to? Now, you're an actor over here, a local guy.
I live in Staten Island. I still live in Staten Island.
So alias
thing
you told me. I'm
trying to push
thing
you out.
Yeah. No. Yeah. I love Staten Island. I'd never leave. If I have to leave New York, hopefully it'll be to go to Hollywood, but I'm always going to have my home here. I'll never, ever leave Staten Island. I love it.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah.
Anyway, what have I been up to? Well, I'm here because I'm trying to promote this film that we did. It's called Doughboys.
Mm-hmm.
It's a beautiful movie. It's an Italian-American film about two brothers that have a bakery that's handed down to them throughout the generations.
Right.
And there's lots of twists and turns about
you know, the good brother, the bad brother. You have to come see the movie.
Yeah.
Okay? The movie's going to be playing at the Staten Island Film Festival.
Right.
And you could get information on the film, on the time, date, and venue where it's playing. Mm-hmm. On April 24th. Mm-hmm. They're going to announce everything. So I hope to see everybody there.
Yeah, right.
Bring your cameras. And
yeah,
let's get those flashes going and yeah, have cool. some fun.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about. If you're not having fun in the entertainment business, you might as well quit.
That's it.
And I'm loving it, so I'm never going to quit.
You got to go after your dreams. You got to do what
right?
you want to do in life. Well, also, talking about films, we have Sal Sirchia and Anthony Palladino from a movie called Knock Knock. And we're going to talk with them in a little while. They're going to come up. We have the poster back there. And we got to support each other. You know?
I also would like to plug shamelessly another film that I did. Mm-hmm. It's a horror movie. Mm-hmm. It's called Last Rites of the Dead,
right.
where I play a pretty butt-kicking, tough zombie killer.
Right.
You know, I tried to keep that clean. Did I do good?
That
did I do good with that?
Huh? That
all right. So, hopefully we'll get some people to latch on to that. This year, both movies are going to be released at the same time. Hopefully, by then, people will know my name.
You did the stunts in the movie, right?
The I did the stunt. No, he came in. He did the stunts.
I did double.
Jay just
have
to shave.
No problem. And you wouldn't have to shave your head.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
There you go.
All right.
Well, these guys are in a lot of movies over here. But AJ,
we'll
you in the movies yet?
I'm trying.
We haven't in a movie.
Well, if you call Pee-wee's Great Adventure a movie, yeah.
That's a movie.
That's, yeah. You know.
It's something. Something's better than nothing.
Yeah, I mean, I had to join SAG to be in that movie, so I guess it is.
Yeah, cool.
But, yeah, I'm trying my best.
Well, now you're hanging around all these actors now. Man.
Yeah, you know, and I was just telling Johnny before and Tommy G that, you know, I'm meeting more people here than I've met in the past 10 years.
Andre, he's doing a movie called Priceless.
And he asked me to be in it.
Yeah.
He asked me to play a Russian mob guy.
Johnny Bianco is a producer.
Yeah.
Producer.
So I have to say, your papers are not in order. Right. Like, you know, something like that. So we'll see.
Hmm.
But
all right. So we're gonna get another guest up here. So why don't we bring up Anthony and Sal in the movie Knock Knock, and we'll talk about that.
Absolutely.
I want to thank you for coming on.
It was my
Gaetano.
Pleasure.
We'll bring you on. Festival, we'll bring you on again, and we'll see you down at the film festival. I want to thank you for coming up.
No problem.
All right. We got the guys from the movie Knock Knock over here. You brought Anthony Palladino.
A lot of movies.
But this is Sal's debut. He's like the main actor to the movie.
Yes,
talk a little bit about Knock Knock.
All right, it's a horror movie, slasher movie, and I play Troy. I'm one of the stars. Anthony plays Sheriff Cutter. We have Lou Savarese in the movie and a whole bunch of people, Kim Taggart and Antonio. But anyway, one of the main things I wanted to plug is about that it's playing at the Pioneer Theater. Right. And what is that, in the Village, right? Manhattan, Phil, you see the address there?
So, East 3rd Street between Avenue A and Avenue B.
Right, that's May 7th at 6:30.
You want to check it out.
Yeah, if you want to know more about the movie, you can go to Fangoria.com if you want to see more information about it.
Are you going to be down at Chilla?
Yeah, we'll be down at Chilla.
All right, talk a little about the movie, and we're going to have Anthony's
Fangoria's
part.
Fangoria is doing the screening. So go to Fangoria.com if you want more information about the movie, and just go see it.
Now, you have a part.
I play Sheriff Cutter. Mm-hmm. Sal, he's one of the main guys, main character. Then you got Lou Savarese, like Sal said. It's a horror movie. It's a really great plot, written and directed, by the way, by Joe Ariola, who also did Coalition.
Right.
That Me and Sal Are In.
Right.
Another great movie. That's out on Blockbuster if you want to see it.
You're in a lot of Joe's movies.
Oh, two. He only did two. So
we also have another actor from Coalition right over here.
Yeah. Where?
Right over here. From Coalition.
Sorry. There he is. Yeah. That's right.
He's in the background. All right, talk about your role in the movie.
In the movie, in
Sheriff.
In Knock Knock. Yeah, well, I play Sheriff Rob Cutter. He's a small town sheriff, like a good old boy kind of guy. Right. Drives a Jeep. Mm-hmm. never finds out. It doesn't catch anybody, really.
Yeah. It's just that never happens in
No. Kids get killed.
Yeah.
That's about it.
Yeah.
Kim Taggart, the beautiful Kim Taggart, is in this movie. She plays Detective Vega.
Mm-hmm.
She smack Sal around a little bit. That was fun. That was a fun scene.
Man, where's your part? Now you're the big actor.
I'm whacked out. I'm more freaky. I mean, there was big write-ups in Fangoria magazine saying that I'm convincingly deranged. I was very
convincingly deranged.
So we don't have to act.
Right, I didn't have to act.
There's no acting involved.
I just playing myself.
AJ's.
I was playing myself, you know. And
AJ's like a clone of me. I feel like brothers in ways. Yeah. The little girl, Gina, she's going to come up and rock out. That's Gina Coppola. Coppola.
Angelo's sister.
She's Angelo's sister.
Right.
They come from Detroit, so Detroit rocks. So they're going to come up here and she's going to do a little number for us, all right?
Yeah.
So let's check it out. Hey, there she is.
Wow.
Wow, what a pretty girl.
You want to sit here?
Yeah.
Sit up. Have a seat.
There she is. She's the star.
Hold on, let me give you a microphone.
Yes, she is.
There you go.
You gotta take care of it. All right, Gina, there it is. This is your big fame over here. The lights in the New York City. How you like New York?
Good, huh? It's pretty cool.
Pretty cool?
Yeah, I heard they took you to Times Square.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you're gonna perform a number over here, right?
Mm-hmm.
What's the number you're gonna do here today?
I'm gonna do Fergalicious Hip Hop.
That's your song. You made that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. All right, well, let's give it up. Let's go check it out.
Listen up, y'all, cause this is it. The beat that I'm banging is delicious.
Fergalicious Fergalicious definition make them boys go crazy. They always claim they know me.
Well, you know what? I want to thank everybody that's come on the show here tonight. And we're going to end it with the house band. So let's get the house band to rock out at the end of the show. I want to thank everybody for coming down. New York rocks. Let's do it.
Come on, everybody. Clap your hands. Oh, you're looking good. I'm gonna sing my song, it won't take long. It's called the twist and it goes like a twist again. Like we did last summer, baby. Oh, twist again. Like we did last year. Do you remember when we were really rocking, baby? Oh, twist again. But twist the time is here. Oh baby, round and round, and off and down we go again. Oh baby, don't you want to pop and go again? Oh, twist again, like we did last summer, baby. Whoa, twist again, like we did last year. Hey baby, yo, New York rock, New York rock, yeah, New York rock.
Thank you.
Don't touch that dial. New York Rocks has an exclusive video of One Flesh Girl Fixer. Check it out.
Just stay.